गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, आर यू एबल टू हियर मी?
यस मैडम।
राइट, सो इट हैज बीन दैट आफ्टर 10 डेज वी आर हैविंग द क्लास, राइट? सो इट हैज बीन ऑलमोस्ट 10 डेज, सो कैन एनीवन टेल मी दैट व्हाट वी कवर्ड इन द लास्ट क्लासेस? यस, what was the topic that was covered in the last class? Can anyone tell me? Yes, so at least the students who are maintaining the running notes, they can answer me, right? So what was the topic covered in the last class? Right. So, why students are very less in the class today? Only 16 students are present, 15. At what time your last class has been completed?
1:30.
1:30 na? So, Lavanya madam ekada class teeskundi. Last class.
Yes, ma'am, it ended at 1 o'clock.
Right. So then people can join at 2 o'clock, right? So it is 2:05 already. So let me start the class. So only 17 students are present.
They usually join by 2:10, ma'am.
Okay. Right. So let me discuss at least what are the topics covered in the third unit. So you'll be having mid exams in the next week, right? I hope you know the information, So as you all know, it is objective mode only, okay? Online exam it will be. So it is very easy for you, I think so, right?
So we made life, ma'am.
Mostly, right? So in the third unit, we discuss some definition. What is mean by at rest earth pressure condition, right? Passive earth pressure condition, active earth pressure condition, right? And we also discussed variation of earth pressures, right? So how the earth pressure varies, and when it will be minimum, and when it will be maximum, the earth pressure, right? And all the discussion is only about lateral earth pressure. Okay, so in the geotechnical engineering, we have studied about vertical stresses, vertical pressures, and in the foundation engineering, and in this third unit, first chapter, we'll be discussing on lateral earth pressure. Okay, so we started with one derivation, right? So Rankine's earth pressure theory, or at rest earth pressure. Okay, so we were discussing the derivation for at rest earth pressure condition. Okay, so we'll see the derivation, okay, for at rest earth pressure condition. Okay, so what is the earth pressure that will be developed, okay, in the horizontal direction? Okay, so see, only if you maintain the notes, then you can understand the derivations, and you'll be getting some doubts. Okay, so I'll be sharing the video for you. So it is the derivation of earth pressure at rest condition derivation. Okay, so it is the calculation of earth pressure in the horizontal direction. Okay.
Good morning, students. Today we'll derive the expression for coefficient of earth pressure at rest condition, right? So at rest condition means there is no.
So is it video is visible for you, students? So are you able to hear the voice? Yes. Are you able to hear the voice from the video? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Right. So I'm going to play the video. Watch the video carefully. Okay. So then only you can understand the derivation. So maintain the notes. Okay. At least for the derivations part. Okay.
Moment of retaining wall. Okay. So the retaining wall is in stable position. That condition is called as at rest condition. In this condition, what is the total pressure that is exerted by the backfill, whichever is there on the back side of the retaining wall, that we will calculate and see. Okay. So earth pressure, the pressure exerted by the earth in the rest condition whenever there is no movement of retaining wall. So it is represented with K naught. Okay. So K naught is the coefficient of earth pressure at rest condition, which is equal to sigma x dash by sigma z dash. So coefficient of earth pressure at rest condition is defined as, it is the ratio of effective stress in the x direction to the effective stress in the z direction. So effective stress in the x direction or effective stress in the z direction, that will derive it from the diagram. Okay, that will calculate and see it from the diagram, right? So sigma x dash, how it can be rewritten, the sentence sigma x dash is equal to k naught into.
So you try to write the expression for sigma x dash. Write the expression for sigma x dash.
K naught into sigma z dash. Right? So, from the knowledge that we have, geotechnical engineering second unit, we'll calculate what is sigma z dash. So, sigma z dash is the effective stress in the z direction. Right? So, that we'll calculate from the diagram. So, if you see the diagram here, we considered a element A, which is.
So video is lagging. Okay, so my voice is going a bit faster than the video. So you try to adjust to it. It is because of the quality in the video. Okay.
Which is there at depth Z. Okay. And stresses are acting in the x direction and also in the z direction, right? And water table is present at the depth of ZW, right? So this is what there in the diagram. So consider the unit weight of soil to be gamma. Unit weight of soil, gamma, right? So now calculate what is effective stress. As we know, the general formula for effective stress is total stress minus pore water pressure, right? Total stress minus pore water pressure. So from the diagram, for total stress is unit weight of soil into depth, right? So the element is considered at depth Z. So unit weight into Z minus pore water pressure. So it is a pressure exerted by the water which is there in the pores of the soil. So that will be equal to, so whenever we are writing the formula for pore water pressure, it should be expressed only with the gamma, mainly with the gamma W, right? Water, unit weight of water into. So from the diagram, we can write it as ZW, right? So this is the effective stress in the z direction.
So students, wait for 1 minute. 1 minute, I'll share the screen once again because the video is lagging a lot. Okay. So let me share the screen once again. Wait for a minute. Okay. Calculate what is sigma z dash. So sigma z dash is the effect. So students, are you able to hear the voice? Are you able to see the video? Yes.
Okay, stress in the z direction. Right?
Are you able to see the video?
Yes, ma'am.
Right. So I hope it won't lag again because I am trying to open with another player. Okay.
So that we calculate from the diagram. So if you see the diagram here, we considered element A, which is there at depth z, okay, and stresses are acting in x direction and also in the z direction, right? And water table is present at a depth of zw, right? So this is what there in the diagram. So consider the unit weight of soil to be gamma. Unit weight of soil, gamma. Right? So now calculate what is effective stress. As we know, the general formula for effective stress is total stress minus pore water pressure. Right? Total stress minus pore water pressure. So from the diagram, for total stress is unit weight of soil into depth, right? So the element is considered at depth z. So unit weight into z minus pore water pressure. So it is a pressure exerted by the water which is there in the pores of the soil. So that will be equal to, so whenever we are writing the formula for pore water pressure, it should be expressed only with the gamma, mainly with the gamma w, right? Water, unit weight of water into, so from the diagram we can write it as zw, right? So this is the effective stress in the z direction. So consider this as equation 2 and this to be equation 1. Now substitute equation 2 in 1, right? So what is the equation that we'll get now? So we'll get sigma x.
So can you tell me the equation for sigma x dash now? after substituting equation 2 in 1, can you tell me the expression for sigma x dash?
K naught into gamma z minus gamma w into z double.
Right. Okay. So verify.
X dash is equal to K naught into, okay, sigma z dash is written as gamma z minus gamma w z w. Right. So it is a effective stress in the z in the x direction. Right. Right, now let us calculate what is the total stress. Total stress. So we all know the basic formula for total stress is effective stress plus pore water pressure. Pore water pressure. So effective stress, okay, effective stress from the above equation is K naught into gamma z minus gamma w into z w plus, what is pore water pressure from the diagram? It is gamma w into z w, right? So this is the total stress, right? Stress, total stress or total earth pressure, okay, total lateral earth pressure, sigma is equal to K naught into gamma z minus gamma w z w plus gamma w z w, right? So this is the total lateral earth pressure equation, right? So it is represented with letter sigma, right? Now when the soil is dry, okay, total earth pressure sigma equal to K naught into gamma into H. The H represents the height of retaining wall. So this is the total earth pressure that is there at the bottom of the retaining wall. Okay, K naught into gamma H is the pressure that is there at the bottom of retaining wall. If you draw the effective stress diagram, we'll understand that. Okay, when the soil is dry, this is what happening. So now we'll see the lateral earth pressure per unit length of wall. Okay, total lateral earth pressure per unit length of wall. Is sigma equal to K naught into gamma into H. Or let us write it is Z into DZ. Okay. So let us apply the integration, okay, from 0 to H, right? Total pressure force per unit length okay, per unit length, sigma is equal to k naught into gamma z into dz. Let us apply integration from the limits 0 to h. So height of the retaining wall is h.
So students, apply the integration and substitute the limits in it and tell me what is sigma after substitution, after integration and the limit substitution. Can you tell me the equation for sigma after substitution of limits?
Gamma.
Gamma.
H square by 2.
So k naught. Where does k naught goes? Your voice is breaking.
K naught into gamma h square by 2, ma'am.
Right.
Integration for this equation. So after applying the integration, the equation will become like this. K naught into gamma into z square. By 2, right? Apply the limits from 0 to h, right? So after applying the limits, the equation will turn out to be h square by 2, right? So this is the total stress that is present whenever there is no water table, right? And it is the total pressure for unit length of the wall. Right. So now we'll see the equation for total pressure, for total lateral pressure whenever there is water table, right? So water table is present at depth D, okay? If you see in the diagram, okay? So when water table is at D depth. So how the equation will change? Okay, equation of total lateral earth pressure, okay, that is sigma. So it is a test condition, so we can write it to be sigma naught. Okay, sigma or sigma naught is equal to k naught into gamma into z minus gamma w z minus d plus. So as it is the total stress, so this is the equation for effective stress, and whatever we are writing now, gamma w into z minus d, okay? So this is a pore water pressure, okay? So let me mention this here. So this is effective stress. And this is pore water pressure. So this is the equation for total lateral earth pressure. Okay. So whenever there is water table. Okay. So now let us take k naught to the inside. So we'll write the equation like this. Okay. So sigma or sigma naught at rest, okay, k naught into gamma d okay? K naught gamma dash z minus d plus gamma w z minus d, right? So this is a generalized equation, right? So this is a generalized equation. When water table is present at a depth d. Now we'll see the equation. When z is equal to h, okay, or d equal to h, d equal to h. So what does it mean? Okay, so it means water table is at ground surface, is at depth h. So now we will write when z equal to h, total stress equation, okay? So that will be equal to sigma naught, okay, k naught gamma h plus, okay, k naught gamma dash h minus d plus gamma w h minus d. So what we did here, so we have taken water table which is there at d, and we shifted this water table to the depth h, okay, in this condition. So the equation will be like this. Now we'll see when water table, okay, when d equal to 0, which means water table. Now we are considering d equal to 0. It means water table is at ground surface. So what we did, we shifted the water table to the top surface. We made the d to be 0. We'll see what will be the total earth pressure at rest condition, right? So k naught, this first term will become 0, the second term will be k naught gamma dash, okay, d equal to 0. So only z will be there in the second term, and only gamma w z will be there in the third term, okay? So the total pressure will vary at the rest condition when the water table is shifting. When water table is at depth d, it is the equation. When water table is at depth h, this is the equation. When water table is shifted to the top surface, ground surface, then the equation will turn out to be like this. The total lateral earth pressure will vary like this, according to the water table position.
Any doubts, students, in this? Do you have any doubts? Yes? Do you have any doubts? So it was the derivation for at rest condition. Earth pressure derivation for at rest condition. Now we'll see one more derivation, okay, on Rankine's earth pressure theory. Okay, so Rankine is a scientist who has given the derivations for earth pressure in active state, in passive state, for cohesionless soils and for cohesive soils, and also when the soil is inclined. So even in that case, Rankine has given his expressions for lateral earth pressure. Okay, so in today's class, let us discuss Rankine earth pressure theory. So are you able to see the screen? Are you able to see the PPT? Are you able to see the PPT? Students?
Yes, ma'am.
So let us discuss Rankine's earth pressure theory. Okay, so Rankine has made some assumptions before deriving the expression.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
You are unable to see the PPT. Yes or no? Yes or no? Tell me. Shall I share the screen once again?
Yes, ma'am. Visible, ma'am.
Okay. So Rankine has made assumptions, right? So the first assumption, if you see, soil is homogeneous and...
Ma'am, it's visible.
Ma'am, it is visible, ma'am.
Right. Soil is homogeneous and semi-infinite, okay? So I hope you all know the meaning of homogeneous soil and semi-infinite soil. Okay, many times it was discussed in the geotechnical engineering class. Okay, the soil is dry and cohesionless. Okay, so what does it mean? If the soil is cohesionless, means what does it mean? What happens to the C?
C dash equal to zero. C.
C or C dash is equal to zero. Okay, so the ground surface is plane, which may be horizontal or inclined. Okay, so as of today's class is concerned, we'll be discussing only when the ground surface is plane and the horizontal. Okay, so we'll be seeing the derivation when the ground surface is inclined in the next classes. Okay, and there was one more assumption regarding retaining wall. See, I have given you the definition of retaining wall already. Okay, so the back of the retaining wall is smooth and vertical. He assumed like that. So the retaining wall, sometimes it can be vertical, and it's not compulsory that it should be vertical in all the cases. Okay. And he also made one more assumption, right? So here the back of the retaining wall is smooth. Okay, so it means that he is neglecting the friction forces. Okay, frictional forces he is avoiding. Okay, so whenever it is mentioned like the retaining wall is rough, okay, so there he has to consider frictional forces also. Okay, so to avoid the frictional forces, he is making this assumption that the wall is having smooth surface. Okay, the soil element is in a state of plastic equilibrium, right? So which means that the soil is about to fail. Okay, so the piece of the soil or the slice of the soil or the piece of the slope, whichever is present at back of the retaining wall, so it is about to fail. So whenever the slope or the soil is about to failure, then in that case, we are going to derive this Rankine's earth pressure. Okay. So first we'll be deriving the expression for active earth condition. Okay. So we already discussed what is meant by active earth pressure. Okay. So here, see, in the case of active earth pressure condition, the pressure will be minimum always. Okay. In the case of passive earth pressure, the pressure will be maximum. Okay, so in the diagram it was shown already. Okay, in the active earth pressure condition, it will be minimum. And what is the condition of retaining wall? What is the condition of retaining wall? Can anyone tell me? Active earth pressure means what is the condition of retaining wall? What is the state of retaining wall? Yes.
Forward wave, moves
fast. What?
The wall moves forward.
So the wall will move in the right direction or left direction? That you need to mention.
left direction.
Right, in the left direction, right? So the soil is exerting some pressure, because of that the wall will try to fall on the left side. Okay, so we discuss the diagrams also for all this. Okay, so it is the first step is very simple. Okay, as you have seen in the derivation. Okay, so sigma h is equal to k naught into sigma v. Okay, so what is sigma h here? What is sigma h? What does sigma h is representing?
Minor principal stress.
Other than that, it's okay, it's correct. Other than that, what you can tell? What does h is representing there? Yes. What does sigma h is representing?
I'm horizontal stress.
Horizontal stress or horizontal earth pressure, right? And which is equal to k naught into sigma v, it is mentioned. What is k naught? What is k naught? It was said in the video. What is k naught? Yes, can anyone tell me what does k naught is representing here? So in whatever video you have seen till now, this k naught letter was there in every step, and I said what is mean by it, what does it represents? Anyone from the class? I asked you to look into the video, focus on the video. What is k naught? Can anyone tell me? Right, so it is the coefficient of earth pressure. Okay, it is the coefficient of earth pressure in the at rest condition. Okay, what is sigma v?
Vertical earth pressure.
Vertical earth pressure, right? So if you see this diagram here, so this horizontal line is representing ground surface, and we are considering a element for analysis which is lying at depth z. Okay, so we selected one soil particle which is located at depth z, and there are stresses that are generated on the soil element, right? So in the horizontal direction we represented the stresses to be sigma h, and which is equal to k naught into sigma v. And even in the vertical direction we represented the stresses with the letter sigma v. Okay, stress in the vertical direction, and which is equal to gamma into z. Okay, so it is generalized formula. Okay, so whenever you see the vertical stress, always it should be in these terms. Okay, unit weight and z. Okay, so this is what you need to understand from this. Okay, and as your friend said, sigma h is a minor principal stress. Okay, and sigma v is the major principal stress. And see, in this condition, okay, so for the derivation purpose, and Rankine made the sigma v to be constant. Okay, so what are these circles? What is the name of these circles? Can anyone tell me? Yes.
More circles,
right? So if you see the more circles, okay, so the radius is increasing. Okay, so otherwise if you see in this direction, okay, so the radius is decreasing. Okay, or else if you are going like this, from A to A dash, the circle radius is increased from a dash to a double dash, the circle radius is further increased. Okay, so here if you see, the sigma v is constant. Okay, so all the circles, all the three circles are joined here. Okay, these are starting at one point. Okay, so sigma v is constant, and the only thing that is varying here is sigma h. Okay, and sigma h is decreasing. Okay, at failure state or at plastic equilibrium state, it is called as active pressure. Okay, so if you see the radius has been increased, the circle radius has been increased, and at one particular circle is meeting the failure envelope. Okay, so whatever the stresses that are generated here, and with the help of the stresses only, we'll be drawing this more circle, right? So whatever the stresses that are generated here, these are leading the soil to be failure condition. Okay, so whenever the more envelope or a failure envelope is touching the circle, okay, is touching the circle, this condition is called as a failure condition. And whatever the pressure that is existing whenever there is failure, that pressure is called as active pressure. Okay, right, so let us see the derivation for this. Okay, theory in active state or active pressure, active earth pressure will derive now. So see, if this is the Mohr circle diagram. Okay, so as we know already about Mohr circle diagram, so students, are you able to see the video? Yes, are able to see the video. Okay, so we'll be deriving the expression for active pressure, active earth pressure will be calculating first, and it is derived by Rankine. Okay, and whatever we are considering, the soil is cohesionless, so you won't be finding C term in any step. Okay,
okay, so this is a Mohr envelope. More envelope. Right? So on the x axis, normal stress is taken. On the y axis, shear stress is taken. Okay. So this is the more envelope, and here it is a more circle, and it is drawn with the radius. And we use the more circle mainly to represent a major and minor principal stresses. Okay, so in the diagram, if you see, so there is some geometry involved here. Okay, so O to E distance is considered as PA, means the pressure in the active state, and the radius from O to B is considered as sigma V, vertical stress, or it is the normal stress in the vertical direction, right? So this is a graphical procedure. Mohr Coulomb's theory or Mohr circle theory is the graphical procedure. Okay, so with the help of graphs, whatever the distances or the radii, whatever we get, that is considered as the magnitudes of stresses or magnitudes of pressure. Okay, so first, what is there from the diagram, what we can write from the diagram. Okay, so here if you see PA, okay, PA is equal to OE, we can write from the diagram, right? Which is equal to OC minus CE. So this is the equation 1. Okay, so in the equation 1 we have written the expression for PA, okay, pressure in the active state. Now we'll see what is CE. Okay, so what we can write about CE? CE is equal to DC or CD, right? CA is equal to CD, right? And which is equal to OC sin phi, right? So how it is possible? Since sin phi is equal to CD by OC. Right? So this is from trigonometry, right? So now we have written the expression for CA. Okay, CA is equal to OC sin phi dash, right? So consider this to be equation 2. Okay, now substitute 2, equation 2 in 1, right? So the equation for PA will be equal to, right, OC minus OC sin phi dash, right? Sin phi dash. So let us take OC to be common. OC 1 minus sin phi dash. So this is the expression that we got for PA, right? So now let us write the expression for sigma V. Okay, so sigma V is the vertical stress, normal stress in the vertical direction. So it is equal to OB, right? So if you see the diagram, OB is equal to sigma V, right? And which is equal to OC plus CB, right? OC plus CB, right? So from the diagram we can say CB is equal to CE again, right? So we got the expression for CE here, right? Now consider this to be equation 3, right? So substitute 2 in 3, right? So CB is equal to CA, we can write, right, from the similar triangle principle, right? So sigma V is equal to OC one plus sin phi dash. Okay, let us write the expression now for PA by sigma V. Okay, so PA is equal to what? OC by 1 minus sin phi dash, right? Sigma V is equal to what? OC of 1 plus sin phi dash, right? So let us cancel these terms, OC, and which is equal to PA by sigma B is equal to 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus equation will become PA is equal to.
Students, are you able to see the video properly? Yes?
No, ma'am.
Is it lagging for everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so it might be...
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so the video is available in the YouTube already. Okay, you can check once again, but let me check once again. Okay, it may be due to the signals. Okay, it is cloudy here.
1 minus sine phi dash 1 plus. Now we are writing the expression for PA because we want the expression for pressure in the active state, right? Which is PA is equal to pressure in the active state. PA is equal to 1 minus sine phi dash by 1 plus sine phi dash into sigma V. So, this can be rewritten like this, okay, PA is equal to, okay, so this term is replaced with KA, and we all know that the total stress in the vertical direction is equal.
So, is it okay now at least? Yes, is it okay? Students, is that video is lagging again?
Answer. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Right. So there are only two steps that are there. So let us finish this and end up the class. Okay.
Into gamma into z. Right. So it is always the multiplication of two terms, that is unit weight and the depth, right? So the PA will be equal to now KA into gamma Z. So this is the standard equation for pressure in the active state, okay? Lateral earth pressure in the active state, right? So what is that we understood from this, okay? What is KA here? KA equal to 1 minus sine phi dash by 1 plus sine phi dash. So what is KA here? Okay. So KA is the coefficient of earth pressure in the active state, which is equal to 1 minus sine phi by 1 plus sine phi. Okay.
Let me take the attendance. Okay. So you can watch the remaining video by YouTube. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
So I hope you all know my YouTube channel name. Okay. So
yes, ma'am.
Videos are uploaded according to the titles of the topic. Okay. So I'll continue the video in the next class also, if possible. Okay.
మ్యామ్ 47 కూడా అటెండెన్స్ అయ్యారు వాళ్ళు ఇందాక
47 ఎవరు
ప్రశాంత్ మేడం ప్రశాంత్ మేడం
ఓకే ఏంటి రెండు సార్లు ఓకే I am ending the class. Thank you, students. I have taken the attendance. Okay.